Have you ever tried to upload or share a video only to realize that the file is way too big? Video files take up a ton of space, especially when compared to documents or photos, but there's an easy fix. Today, we're breaking down how to compress video files without losing quality. Whether you need a smaller file for faster uploads, to meet platform size limits, or to simply save on some storage space. And if file size isn't an issue, we'll also show you the best settings for the highest quality render possible. What we won't be covering is the technical details of compression, codecs, or containers. There are already great resources for that, which I've linked in the description below. Additionally, we won't be covering how to export videos in WebM for web use, but I've included helpful resources for that in the description as well. Instead, this video is divided into two parts. First, we'll go over how to compress a single video file while preserving the best possible quality. Then, we'll take a look at exporting from Premiere Pro and After Effects. First, optimizing for a balance of quality and file size, and then focusing purely on achieving the highest possible quality. If you just need to shrink a video file, one of the best free tools for the job is HandBrake. It's an open source video compressor that's easy to use and works on both Mac and Windows. First, download and install HandBrake from handbrake.fr. Open the app, load your video file, and choose MP4 as your format. Then, under the video settings, change the codec to H.265 X265. This is the best option for balancing quality and file size. HandBrake also offers H.265 Video Toolbox, which uses Apple's hardware acceleration to significantly speed up encoding. If you're in a rush and need a faster export, Video Toolbox is a good option. However, it may result in slightly larger files and less efficient compression compared to X265. Additionally, the 10-bit and 12-bit options provide better color fidelity. But unless you're working with HDR footage, H.265, X265 will give you the best results here. Next, set constant quality RF to somewhere between 18 and 22. Lower numbers mean higher quality, but a larger file size. Keep the frame rate set to same as source, and you're good to go in this section. For the best balance of compression, quality, and encoding speed, adjust the preset, tune, profile, and level settings. Set the preset to slower for the best compression without excessively long encoding times. If you need a faster render, choose medium instead. In most cases, leave the tune set to none for the best balance of quality and efficiency. However, if you're working with grainy footage, selecting grain can help preserve detail while improving compression. If you're interested in other tuning options, such as settings for animation or optimizing for fast decoding, we've linked a full breakdown of HandBrake's tune settings in the description down below. Keep the profile setting on auto to ensure the best compression efficiency and color accuracy for the rest of your selected settings. And finally, keep the level set to auto as well, so HandBrake automatically selects the best level based on your resolution and frame rate. Once you're ready to encode, browse to select where you'd like to save the final file, click Start, and HandBrake will compress your file while maintaining excellent quality. If you have an Adobe Creative Cloud subscription, you can get similar results with Adobe Media Encoder. Just drag your video into the queue, set the format to HEVC H.265, and choose Match Source High Bitrate as the preset. Then, click the preset options to open the Export Settings menu. Set bitrate encoding to VBR 1 pass and adjust the target bitrate. For 1080p, set it between 10 and 15 megabits per second. And for 4K, set it to between 25 and 40 megabits per second. Click OK and then select where you'd like to save the file by clicking the highlighted path under the Output File column. Select the Start Queue Play button icon and Media Encoder will export your file to the selected destination. By now, we've established that H.265 HEVC is the best option for maintaining quality while reducing file size. So let's go straight into how to export H.265 from Premiere Pro and After Effects using Media Encoder. To export a video in Premiere, open your final sequence and go to File, Export, Media. Under Format, select HEVC H.265, click the Preset dropdown, and choose Match Source, High Bitrate. If you don't see it, you may need to search for it in the Preset Manager. You can open the Preset Manager by scrolling down to the bottom of the Preset Options, and then clicking More Presets. With the correct preset selected, click Send to Media Encoder, and your sequence will be sent to render. Now, let's look at that same process in After Effects. Open your final composition and go to Composition, Add to Adobe Media Encoder Queue. That's it. Now you can open Media Encoder to update the format and preset as mentioned earlier in the video. Now, if you need the absolute highest quality without a limitation on file size, you should export in ProRes 4444 or ProRes 4444 with alpha if you need transparency. ProRes 4444 Technically, you can use ProRes 4444XQ for an even higher data rate, but that's really just a tiny difference in quality that I don't think is worth it. To render in ProRes from Media Encoder, set the format to QuickTime or Apple ProRes MXF OP1A. Then select the preset of ProRes 4444 or 4444 with alpha if you're rendering an animation intended to be used as an overlay. Just like the overlays that you can find over on Storyblocks. Different platforms have their own compression recommendations, so it's a good idea to check their guidelines before you export. You can find a helpful article containing the best settings for most platforms in the description. And finally, you may have noticed that we didn't cover DaVinci Resolve in this video. That's because we've actually already made a separate video on how to export specifically from Resolve. You can find that video linked in the description as well. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Then head over to storyblocks.com for unlimited downloads of royalty-free 4K footage, templates for Premiere Pro and After Effects, music, and more.